When it came to public affairs, 13 continued to capture the drama of real-life stories.
And I still, to this day, counsel, don't see anything wrong with taking the Ayatollah's money and sending it to support the Nicaraguan freedom fighters.
Executive producer Al Perlmutter and journalist Bill Moyers broadcast The Secret Government, an in-depth and uncompromising expose of the Iran-Contra scandal and covert CIA operations leading up to it.
I'm Bill Moyers, and in this personal essay, we'll look at that government in the shadows. Next week, Congress will publish a report on the Iran-Contra scandal. My colleagues and I have been investigating it ourselves.
I've been waiting for something to happen.
We led off the program with a song by Jackson Browne called Lives in the Balance, which very graphically showed the implications of warfare, weapons provision, and so on.
When you know that you've seen it before, where a government lies to a people, and a country is drifting to war.
The story broke 1 year ago. The United States had defied its own embargo.
In November 1986, National Security Council staff member Oliver North came into the public spotlight. The Iran-Contra affair uncovered a secret Reagan administration program to sell arms to Iran and divert the proceeds to support the anti-communist rebels, or Contras, in Nicaragua.
Those charges are utterly false.
Senator John Kerry of Massachusetts, a veteran of the Vietnam War, is a member of the Senate Foreign Relations Committee.
They were willing to literally put the Constitution at risk because they believed somehow there was a higher order of things, that the ends do in fact are justified by the means.
Looking back, it's stunning how easily the Cold War enticed us into surrendering popular control of government to the national security state. We've turned the war powers of the United States over to where we're never really sure who or what they're doing or what it costs or who is paying for it. An open society cannot survive a secret government.
The program was a scathing report by Bill Moyers. It was an essay, a commentary, as only Bill Moyers could do. We had the usual complaints that said that public money should not be used to do programs like this. But in actuality, it was the kind of program that public television was meant to do and should be doing and should be doing more of. And you'll never find it on commercial television. You would never be able to get a program like this on the air, but that's public television.